today, I hope that you haven't been put off too much by the delay. Today we are going to look at how you can make your apps crash with style and benefit from it. Anyone of you knows where this picture was made? Who are down here? Well, you apparently know about the incredible intelligence of the Austrian Federal Railway Service. They thought a first-class carriage makes a good compression test object. Well, either way, about me, this picture is about as old as this talk is. This is how I used to look when I still was younger. 10 years of traveling around and holding talks made you look like this. She is here today as a care. So what is what we're going to look at today? First of all, we're going to take a look at why traffic crashes. Because, I mean, normally one doesn't want an app to crash. And if the app crashes, that's terrible. But traffic crashes can actually be quite helpful. I'll explain this in a minute. Then we'll look at some basic and finally at some more advanced methods. The source code is available, or it used to be available when this talk was held for the first time. If the link doesn't work anymore, send me an email and it will be provided to you. So, first of all, the question, why should we track crashes? Who of you has an idea why we should track crashes? To improve the application, that's a good idea. This is why I'm talking to this line in protest. Okay. So, the biggest problem basically we have is the market is crowded. So if you get a batch of bad ratings, your app is basically dead. But most users are egotists, and cuddling them a little bit makes them love you. I have some users in Hungary, it's a female actually, she's in the government, and she sent me an email once she wanted a function. And I sent you back a friendly long email with blah, 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 yes, I will implement your function. This in your brain translated to, the developer responds to me, I am important. And the final effect was that she actually went out to buy another phone to give me a second good rating. And furthermore, motivated to an entire governmental department that the good Mr. Hanlan is so friendly to her that they all must use our app. So, why should we track crashes? Maybe you can still remember Matthew A. Brenner, a good friend of mine, from last year's Deutschland. He stated, isn't it better not to crash? I answer, yes, but the number of lines of code is ever increasing. You can't test everything. Fragmentation, well, it's not a big problem, but sometimes some weird manufacturers, sorry, build some kind of crap in the operating systems of their phones which permanently break down. I've had 3 Sony phones, all of them broke down. None of them were repaired. And finally, there's market pressure. So in the end, as a mobile app developer, you face a problem like supersonic aircraft. The Russians with the Tupolev 144 said, fuck it, we'll risk one accident in 10 million flights. They got an aircraft off the ground shrink-proofed, whereas the Concorde only could live due to cheap central bank money. Well, there is another reason for tracking crashes on the computer. If a crash happens, usually the user just throws his phone against the wall or kicks your app off the phone. But if they actually get in touch with you, the situation is much better. Asking them something like, what operating system version do you use, can be perceived as an insult. This literally happened to me once with a customer. It was another woman, also from Hungary, from the same governmental department. She had an ancient Android phone. Ancient! I have an ancient Windows phone, but we can't mention that. sense to track more than just crashes. I'll just throw some chocolate randomly. If you have the framework for crash tracking set up, you can very quickly extend it to stat tracking. Stat tracking, in principle, is two different fields of discipline. The stat tracking analyzes how the user moves through the application, where he enters the app, where he exits the app, whereas the cache tracking analyzes where the user's dying.
Enter.
contains further information. Essentially, this has to be implemented by food. No ready-made libraries are available because it's different for every application. In Denmark, we have an example, and it's already called Amsterdam. Sadly, the woman who normally gives the example is ill today, so there is no example for this. But in principle, it's very, very easy. You just have a special dialogue which opens if the user enters the secret key combination. For example, I am home or something like that. Then he gets a dialogue, and this dialogue gives further options which are meaningful only to the support team. A classic option, for example, is connect to server and transmit all user data. I mean, I have that in TouchPad. There is a special dialogue where they can transfer their entire remnant variables to the server. And they get back a number on the screen. Your data set is the number 624. Tell it to your support agent, 624. And then they say, 624, and then the support agent, basically usually me or Funstein, see on the screen whatever our girly or boy customer has in this phone and can debug it on this phone. Well, when it comes to handling crashes, the easiest thing is to simply use the thread setting fault exception handler. Just write file, make the app die, and hope that the user eventually emails you the log. This, however, has some problems.